Let us now study about the hydrogen spectrum, which was the basis of need of discovery of different atomic models. Hydrogen spectrum was plotted by electric discharge of hydrogen gas. When hydrogen gas is excited to higher energy levels and when electrons from higher energy level drops back to lower energy level in various paths, the radiation emitted by the hydrogen gas is passed through a device which is called spectrometer. And in this spectrometer, all these wavelengths which are incident from the hydrogen gas are arranged in increasing or decreasing order, and finally on a photographic plate, these wavelengths are allowed to incident. So here in this situation, say the order of lambda is decreasing here. Here order of lambda is decreasing, that means the value of energies are increasing. When the wavelengths are arranged in decreasing order and these are allowed to incident on the photographic plate, corresponding to each wavelength, a spectral line is plotted, or you can say a zone where the material of photographic plate is washed away. A line is plotted over there, which is called a spectral line. These all lines on the obtained on the photograph of this spectrometer screen are called spectral lines. And this arrangement of these spectral lines we call hydrogen spectrum. So let us first have a look on a specific hydrogen spectrum of which the photograph is taken in a laboratory. Let's have a look on this picture. So student, this is a real picture of a hydrogen spectrum which is taken by a spectrometer when different wavelengths are allowed to incident from hydrogen gas onto the spectrometer. Here you can see the spectrum which I've taken here is in increasing order of wavelengths from left to right. Here you can see the leftmost line which is plotted is corresponding to that of the least wavelength or maximum energy, which is that of the last line of the Lyman series, that is corresponding to transition infinite to 1. And you can see adjoining there are many different lines, and this is the line which is corresponding to the spectral series in which the transition of electron is taking place from 2 to 1. And the term which I have used, that of a spectral series, is given for the group of lines which are corresponding to the transition from any higher orbit to 1. This group is named as S1. Similarly, there is another group which is named as S2. This is corresponding to the electron transitions from any higher orbit to n equals to 2. Like this is the line which is corresponding to transition of electron from infinite to n equals to 2, and this is corresponding to transition from 3 to 2, and all other lines are successive lines corresponding to the transition from this from 3 to 2, this 4 to 2, and so on. And again, this is a group of spectral lines which are obtained by electron transition from any higher orbit to n equals to 2. This is also given a separate name because this group is also considered as a spectral series. Similarly, another spectral series is obtained, that is for the transition corresponding to infinity to 3, and this corresponding to the transition from 4 to 3. Similarly, this one will be for 5 to 3, this one will be from 6 to 3, and so on. Now, in this situation, further also there are other spectral series obtained, but higher spectral series, you can see as we are moving away, the width of spectral series is increasing. So next spectral series overlaps with this series, that's why we have not drawn that series over here. But in coming section, we are going to discuss in detail about these spectral series and the specific names given to these spectral series also.